know, once in a while, Mike finds a body stuck in the press.
No shit.
Nah, I'm just kidding. People who cause trouble get thrown off the pier.
Why is this?
Came in and get on the main highway going west. Don't go back to the city.
Maybe it's bad out there.
Say, what's in this?
We need some of the pack.
Better with some money in my pocket.
Hey, what's the rush? Money don't buy you happiness, you know.
Get the fuck out of here.
Nah, I was just fucking with you. Don't worry about the money. This little job is just the beginning. Pretty soon you'll be rolling in it.
So, Sand Island's still the same shithole it was when I left?
No, the place actually ain't too bad now.
How the hell that happened?
All the mollies flew south for the winter. Of course it's still a shithole. You've only been gone a couple of years. It's gonna take a lot longer than that for that neighborhood to turn around. Them people multiply. It's even worse than when we was kids. They even got some kind of gang there now. What's their fucking name? The Demons, the Boomers, something like that. I don't fucking know.
That's fucking great.
Hey, what are you worried about? They're animals. All they do is sell dope with each other. They ain't gonna bother a guy like you. And even if they do, that's why I gave you that pistol.
You're carrying a gun now? What's the deal with that?
Do business without it these days. Especially in this fucking neighborhood.
You, know how to inspire confidence, don't you?
Those Spitfires may be the more popular song now, as British Spitfire fighter planes have finally taken out a key Nazi factory. One that produced fuel for none other than the dreaded B-2 rocket. After several weeks of merciless punishment by this long-range menace, Londoners can breathe a sigh of relief now that the Royal Air Force appears to have severely crippled the Nazi terror for the foreseeable future. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow.
Take a left up here.
Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I'm not going to walk a pop.
In pursuit of a hit and run driver.
Let it snow.
Copy that.
Look at this guy. He never back a day. He's looking for his old neighbor.
Hey, we break him up.
Roger that.
This window shop. It'll be years before he gets one of those things.
You got champagne tastes and beer pockets, my friend. Don't worry, though. I'm going to help you change that.
It's that cream-colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to and go. I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
What if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test. If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right. Just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
Hey, what the fuck are you doing over there?
Ah, shit.
Motherfucker!
over there?
What you doing, motherfucker?
Invasion of Germany. President Roosevelt has concluded his secret meeting with British Prime Minister Winston Churchill to draw up plans for a final offensive against Hitler's army. Not known is why Soviet leader Joseph Stalin was not present. Rumors are swirling that the Soviets may not be invited to participate in the rebuilding process. Either that, or they don't have good vodka in Malta. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris.
But the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I've brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low.
Hey, mission accomplished. How'd it go?
Yeah, piece of cake. Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Not this their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Nice. No stains. Clean.
The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I'd give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like you, buddy Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. See you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
All right, let's go home. I'm exhausted. I don't know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always got a scandal. He deals with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I heard he used to stick up gas stations back in the day.
You gonna make him pay the cleaning bill for your jacket?
Nah, I'll let that one slide. I do a lot of business with the guy. Plus, he's got one hell of a temper. One time he was at the track and some mitt spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye. Lousy temper.
Sounds like kind of a scumbag.
Hey, you just got an out of hand to these people. And Mike's a pussycat compared to some of the guys I've met since you shipped out. You'll see.
Hey, is there a safe place to park around here? I don't want to leave this thing out in the street.
Yeah, that's why you're parking your car next to mine in the garage. The streets are full of criminals these days.
Yeah, the neighborhood ain't what it used to be, huh?
hungry. There's some food in the refrigerator. You hungry, V? Whatever you want from the fridge.
Joe's pleasure, pal. It's Vito speaking.
Vito, why didn't you come home last night? I was worried sick.
Mama?
Mama?
I didn't know you had Joe's number. And whose phone is this?
So have you spoken to Mr. Pappalardo? Find yourself a job?
Yeah, he told me to come by and see him today. Hopefully he's got some work for me.
Okay, Vito. Good luck, mio bambino.
All right, bye, Mama.
Bye, Mama.
Okay, I understand.
Hey! Hey! Turn that down!
Good morning.
Joe's pleasure, pal. Yeah, I'm looking for a Mr. Papalotto.
Yeah? Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Papalotto at your service. You can call me Derek. I think I remember your dad. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
He's dead.
Oh, well. Y'all gotta go sometime. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, man? Huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
Follow me. Load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get 10 bucks. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
And you can keep the 10 bucks. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here, then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit, nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for 10 bucks. What the hell are you doing? Come with me.
Thank you.
What now? Well, this one don't like manual labor. What the fuck? Said he works with Joe Barbaro. Bullshit.
Yeah, hey, it's better than lugging crates around.
All right, then. Get going.
I'm here to collect the fee for the barber.
Hey, what kind of game you playing?
The kind where you pay what you owe when you don't get hurt. You got a problem with that?
I got a problem with you. Now get out of here before I kick your ass.
Your fucking money.
Yeah, glad you decided to reconsider. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Yeah. I must have forgot or something.
Next time, try to pay on time, okay? Thanks. Hey. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Sure, here it is. I don't want no problems.
Don't leave it until the last minute next time. Pal, Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Look, asshole, I'm not in the mood. Why don't you get out of my face before you get hurt?
No can do, pal. Derek wants his money.
Derek can kiss my ass. What's that fat fuck gonna do? Have me killed?
Hey, you said it, not me.
Why don't you give it a try then, asshole?
Watch out! Watch out!
Anybody else?
Got a fucking problem with paying for the fucking barber?
Here's the money, boss man.
Good job. Here's your share. I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Yeah. Right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain.
Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. Say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, we'll do. I'll see you later.
Vito,
I almost forgot. Joe called. He wants you should meet him at Freddy's.
Thank you.
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. I think he's got something big for us.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shuttle. Here, he's coming. Don't say nothing stupid.
Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hiya, Joe. This the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry.
You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen, I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
Where can we get them?
Any office of Price Administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Agnello. Here's the address. Tell her I say
it. All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
But what's the job pay?
I'll give you $600 for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, we're in.
No, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe.
So? What do you say, Vito?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you. You never know what's gonna happen. Better to be safe than sorry. I got beef.
Wait. This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back here and we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see
you. Good luck, Vito.
Can I help you?
Yeah, hello, ma'am. Henry Tomasino sent me. He said you might be able to help me with a little problem down at the Office of Price Administration.
Yeah, I heard about that. What do you need from me?
I need to get in there tonight.
All right, tell you what. My sister's in the hospital right now. If you give me a lift over there, I'll tell you everything you need to know. It's right across the street from the OPA, so it ain't like you're going to be going out of your way.
Sure, no problem.
I'm doing great.
Okay, let's go. And take it easy behind the wheel, all right? I see the way you kids drive these days. All right, kid. The place is locked up pretty tight at night, so you gotta get into the back.
They keep the back door open at night?
No, but the basement window usually is, so that's how you can get in. You're looking for the safe, right?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. It's on the top floor. So's the director's office. That's where the keys are.
Okay. So I go in through the window and back.
Sure thing,
pal. Then head upstairs to the director's office, right?
Right. And be careful. There's guards in there at night. Don't let them see you.
All right. Almost done there, boss. We'll be back on the road in no time. Anything else I can do for you?
Thank you.
See ya.
The office is across the street. Okay, thanks for the ride, kid.
Thanks, Maria. I'll see you.
while I finish my puzzle.
I'm gonna go make the rounds.
Good riddance. Good riddance.
This is where the key should be. All right, here's the key. Now I gotta get to the safe. Ah.
This is the Empire Bay Police Department. We have you surrounded. Come out with your hands up. If you do not surrender immediately, we will open fire.